Hi. I'll be talking about mentorship program contents and mentor projects for She Code Africa. So my name is Sharon Ibeji. I'm a machine learning researcher, and I'm currently the technical coordinator for the data science channel in She Code Africa. And honored to be representing the community today to talk about our mentorship program. So before I proceed, I would like to talk a brief about what our community is all about. So She Code Africa is an organization that creates a platform for African women in tech. We are currently having over 6,000 women across Nigeria, Uganda, Kenya, South Africa, different African countries coming together for a single purpose to grow, to develop. So we have different technical fields of focus, which are backend development, front-end, DevOps, mobile development, product design, product management, data science, and of course, technical writing. So for each of these technical fields, we have respective channel activities and mentorship programs. So every member of the community has a channel they belong to depending on their technical field. So our founder is Adam Duka Onyum, which founded the organization in 2016. And it's currently coordinated with her team of leaders of various chapters, programs, and channels. So at She Code Africa, we have channels in different locations, in different locations, such as schools, states. So we have smaller communities across Africa for closer mentorship, closer support, closer networking and all that. So being a non-profit organization, we are solely concerned about raising and empowering more women in tech so as to bridge the gender gap in tech. And we really want to give more women a voice in this tech industry. So our mission is to build a community that embodies technical growth, networking, mentoring, and visibility among all levels and career roles in technology. Now, the core of our discussion today, our mentorship program, what we do is we pair technical field experts with mentees who are starting out their career, who are just getting into their journey in their various industries of interest. So these are people who want to develop technical and soft skills. Our mentees are grouped into teams. So depending on the field of interest, we group them into teams of probably six, and then we assign a mentor of that field to them who would support them, oversee what they do, direct them, give them resources, and I'll talk further on this content in the next slide. So this program runs as a cohort for 3 months, and within these 3 months, we are hopeful that some sort of impacts will be laid in this mentees. And then for each of these teams, we have a person of contact who checks up. So we do not just leave them and let them be. We have a person of contact that checks up on them on a weekly to find out if there are blockers, if there are challenges, and try to solve them or just try to keep them going. So they check up on mentees and on mentors. So to go further and then to talk more on this, all mentors in She Code Africa work with a template. So these templates are expected by mentors to be customized depending on their technical field. So they draft out what resources, tasks, learning tracks that are important to these mentees on a weekly basis. So depending on their field, they know what should come first and what should come next. And then these are drafted before the commencement of the program. So when the program commences, the learning contents are shared to mentees by their mentors. So every mentee has an idea of what the learning content is going to be like. So for our mentees projects, we have, since our goal is to get them ready, get them set on their career paths, we are not purely focused on technical field alone, on their technical skills alone. We also expose them to non-technical skills so that they could improve in their communication, their writing, their presentation, while they're improving in their technical aspects. So it's a balance. And the whole program is based on a blended learning. They learn with resources that are given out by their mentors, and they, when they have challenges, they go back to their mentors, and on a weekly they meet up with their mentors. So it's an effort from both ends. Now, mentees are expected to accomplish their weekly tasks and share with their mentors. And at the end of every month, a project is given out. So the purpose of this project is to evaluate the performance of those mentees, because we are interested in their growth. We're interested in, are we making an impact? Are we actually raising people? So to evaluate that, both the mentors and the mentees are concerned about this project so as to see how well these people are responding to our program. And finally, there is a capstone project, which the mentees are aware of from the onset. Like I said earlier, they are aware of the learning content right from the beginning of the program. So this capstone project is a means for them to think wide, like what can any project of their choice? They are open to come up with anything they want to do. And then at the end of the project, they present to the mentoring community, and it's a way to show that, yeah, that they actually gained something from this program. Now, on the non-technical aspects, in order to improve their soft skills, all mentees are required to meet with the program leads to share ideas, blockers. So they have the opportunity to meet with all mentees that have the opportunity to meet with themselves along with the program leads to discuss how they are responding, if there are issues, if there are ideas they want, or things that they wish could be implemented in the mentorship program. Then we also invite guests to talk to them concerning how to position themselves in their career paths. For example, how to write a professional CV, personal branding, things like that. And then in the last week of every month, mentees are expected to write either a non-technical or technical article. And this is a form of developing their writing skills. So the goal of everything is to develop the skills of our mentees to make sure that they really understand their career paths, to keep them on track. So a successful mentee is someone that have gone through all this, someone that have taken the resources importantly, and then done the given tasks, interacted with their mentors, and finally did the capstone project. So they are celebrated and we issue them a certificate. So to keep our mentees on track, we, like I said earlier, we monitor them with weekly projects, which most of the times the best mentee in every team is awarded something, probably a data subscription, so as to make sure that they are enjoying the program and they feel they belong, so they keep moving along with the things they need to do and moving along with time. So we believe that at the end of these 3 months, they must have acquired necessary skills that will set them going. So this mentorship program is not to raise professionals. It's to guide people who are trying to develop their skills. So it's a form of helping them focus, know what path to take, know what courses that are necessary and what skills that are more important to them. And it's a way to set them right on their career. So I'm thankful for inviting us at Chicode Africa to talk about our mentorship program. And I hope that I elaborated enough on what our program and the mentors project is all about. And thank you so much for everything. Bye.